Hello and welcome back to Empyrion Galactic Survival Reforged Eden 1.7. My name is Spanj. Welcome back to the irradiated hellhole that we were at last episode. Last episode we did the abandoned arcology over there. Right next to that is an abandoned bunker and an abandoned reactor. So before we get started today, let's cue the music. Well, wasn't that fun? They didn't want to feature the same POIs over and over again, so an idea. I thought I'd put it to some music, see if I can make a montage out of it. That took a long time. Yeah, it took a long time. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed. Welcome. Well, we're still on the same planet, but welcome to the Polaris area. There is a sanctuary here, which I know has some traders in it. The station Lapis, which I know has traders in it. There's where's it gone? There was a, maybe it's not coming up on the thing, but there's a bio lab here, I swear. I wonder if it's not pinging. Anyway, I've managed to get a lot of stuff from those three POIs now, to the point where I've had to sort it because the loot box filled up several times. I suppose, you know, you get the main bits and bobs, like all the parts and stuff. Like we can see here, we've got a lot of various electronics and iron and whatnot. That's great. That's wonderful. We've got some upgrade kits and even plasma coils from our various travels and stuff. We managed to get an Imperial plasma turret.
years. 78,000 CPU requires Zirax plasma cells to fire, obviously, has no gun depression as well. Medium damage versus energy shields cannot be used in both space and atmosphere. So which one is it? Is it space or is it atmosphere? It can't be used in both, though. So it's got a pretty decent range on it. Rate of fire 12 RPM. The range is 231 meters in atmosphere, but I think in space it's close to a kilometer or something crazy. Basically, those red balls that alien thing was firing at us was bloody plasma turrets, right? So there's that. And then we got all these various blocks and stuff and seeds and plants and sprouts and stuff like that. Look at my trade box, though. Keeps it absolutely chock-a-block. We've got so many undelivered cargoes. We've got schematics for bandages, nanite injectors for days, the schematic for rich asteroid mining drills, which I think I've already got. There's another schematic for the thing, all the credit cards. Yeah, it's looking pretty tidy in here. Energy pulse rifle, which of course is broken, and I need to find a Kennex station to sell that in, which means I might have to go all the way back to the starting system, because I'm not sure if Kennex stations exist outside of that. I'm sure they probably do. It's just a case that they're a bit rarer. In the small arms box, though, we've got our heavy assault rifle that we looted. We've also got an assault shotgun now. So, yes! That's a good one to have. That's a very good one to have. Elite combat pistol as well, and a super shotgun. To be honest, I'm not even sure where I picked that up. Super shotgun. Now, last time I used this thing, it was kind of garbo, so we'll see if it's had a little kind of buff and stuff. I don't know, but yeah, the other thing is the meds box is looking reasonably nice, except I need to make a bunch more regeneration kits because I'm going through them like they're going out of fashion. And the fridge in is very healthy, along with the fridge out as well, looking delicious as always. In fact, give me one of them dino stews. They're awesome. So we're pretty stocked. We are absolutely stacked full of stuff and things. Particularly the sort of trade box and the fact that that is full now, and I have to keep emptying it. And the armor and mods box is filling up because, you know, I'm just collecting armor mods like just crazy. So I thought I'd come over here to the Polaris. And good morning. The sun has just come up. This is nice, isn't it? This is the unradiated side of the planet. Although still 6 rads. Got it around. There's the power plant. That doesn't seem to be wanting to give me any kind of like thing about what it is. That's a warehouse, apparently. That's furnaces. I might use those if I can use those. That sanctuary. I'm sure I saw a bio lab when I came down over here. Maybe not. Sometimes it pings up on the radio when you're using the scanner thing. You get this kind of, it comes up and says, "Ooh, bio lab or something detected," and then you actually get to it and it, I don't know, it just doesn't spawn or something goes wrong. Anyway, I went up into space and then came back down again to get here because it was quite far away, and it seems to have disappeared in between that. Never mind, we'll move on. Now this is a regular old trade station. This is like the one we on Roggery. So we're not going to be able to get a lot out of this, I don't think. But let's start with the boxes and stuff. There's quite a few undelivered cargo boxes here to work through. I would like to find a UCH system as well, obviously turn in all these things. Oh, I do need to go back to the starter systems and finish off the surveys and stuff. But who's got the time? And we need to find... somebody said mentioned keeping hold of these because you can find sort of side missions where they ask for them. So that's a good idea. Keep hold of those. Technical artifacts as well. Diamonds, coins. Yeah. Pretty good. We'll turn in some of these. It's good to have some cash available because every now and again we buy stuff from the Talon. Right. We need a massive lag spike. Thank you, game. Now that we've got that out of the way, I need a gin console. Where the hell is it? I thought it was down here. It's obviously different. I'm looking for a ship to Farpoint Station. Are you a Federation captain? No? Oh, well. I like it. There's a gin console right there. Okay, let's turn these in, and then we got a Bertram's over there, and I think that was totally overpowered on our right. We'll try and sell as much stuff as I can, and then we'll move on from this sector, and I think we'll try and find some more trading opportunities and like I said, a UCH ship as well. But we are still on our missions to explore A-type suns, so...
Now, the Sanctuary trade station here is quite interesting. There's got an MA Corp Advanced dude here, and he is selling solar cells. It doesn't. I've just bought them all, so it doesn't. But I just bought solar cells from him. Now, I've heard a lot of chatter about solar cells, people looking for them all over the shop, so... that's good. It's good to know on Sanctuary Irradiated Worlds, assuming there is a Sanctuary on every Irradiated Worlds, solar cells. So I'll take note of that. Wait, this doesn't seem like the kind of thing that pirates would do, which means we have a third-party competition stealing asteroids instead of mining them, but we need proof that they're violating business practices before we can do anything. What I needed to do is find one of the common communication satellites in orbit around the sun, hack its log, and bring communication data back to me. Polaris has authorized me to pay you 64,000 credits. Common communication satellites. Do I have any communication data? Space, work, exploration, and economic. Ha ha ha, come on! No communication data. Even though I have hacked communication satellites, I'm assuming that that means it's just RNG as whether you get one of them. That sucks, man. I was hoping that I'd have one of those. Pax Purgatory, he doesn't want to talk to me. He's just a straight up regular trader. This guy looking for work, I'm interested. I have a service order to repair an older model of heavy armor for a customer that has sentimental value. The parts of this model armor haven't been produced in 10 years. The ones that circle even have been brought up scrapped, which means I need to improvise. Problem is, particular suit is that radiation shielding thermal insulation is completely degraded and there's nothing on the market that can replace it. Sure, I can make something work using 150 graphite and 75 aluminium foil of 50,000 credits. 150 graphite. Ooh. I really should have remembered to bring the graphite from my base because it is just sat there doing nothing at the moment. I'm an idiot. Anyway, I have got a bunch of multi boosts and stuff that I want to sell this guy. Because, you know, it's good to find these traders that buy these. Reckon. All these extra boosts that you end up with. I've just made 1,000,000. Boom! 1,031,000 credits. Come on, let's go. Hell yes. Cool mill. Ta-da! Very nice. Very, very nice. Hey, that's awesome. Well, happy about that. We just made our first 1,000,000. So the thing is, I got these heat exchangers and thruster components, factory units, and salt and stuff sat around and nobody wants it. You're all bastards. You all want stuff that you don't have. How dare you? Right, there's this dude over here. What do you sell? Oh, you're the standard outfitter, so I can sell knickknacks to you for pennies. Except you'll take dual fuel cells at 450. It's not bad. Sorry, a meat at 49. You'll take 35 meat, will you? I think I've probably got that just sat in my fridge, just not really doing anything. Look at that. 65 meat. I don't need it because you can make meat from vegetables and plant protein. I got 400 things. I'm gonna sell my meat. Sell my meat. Sell it. Hey, every little helps, I guess. Whatever. Anyway, so we wanted the graphite. Let's have a look in our trade box here. How much graphite have I got? 92. You wanted 150. So the aluminium foil I can do. The graphite, I suppose I can make a big giant hole in the ground, dig it up. Actually, that's a point. The soil on... When I was digging up the Promethean over here... So I got rid of all those deposits up there. I was getting salt out of the ground, which is great. But I've got a load of salt already. So, I wonder what the soil was like over here. I bet it's just normal graphite. If I can get 150, I only need 58. And then the aluminium foil in my input box. Well, I'll have to make some, but we've got 140 aluminium and 2,000 aluminium powder. Two reactor cores now, by the way. Yas. Look at all the bridges I've got. Matrices and bridges. Yes. This Jupiter here is going to be our next ship, but got a little bit of work before we can bring it in. Right, let me do some diggy diggy, see what we get out of the ground here, and
So there's a silicon deposit. I'll just go dig that up. If we get graphite, then I might just like grind a bit of graphite so we can complete that mission and get a bit more money. Well, no graphite, unfortunately, but I've moved on over to the alien planet in this system. It is just over here. And of course, we were Noggle there. And it looks like there is a large Zirax cluster here. And I think I see, although it's kind of difficult to tell, Gist headquarters. Oh my. It's surrounded in defenses, surrounded in reactors and things like that. And I'm sure the headquarters itself is very heavily defended. I do want to have a little look though, at the very least. And if it's got some weaknesses in there, I mean, it might be reasonably easy to take these defenses out. And then the headquarters itself is probably quite difficult to do, but let's see if we can get this stuff to render in at least so we can actually have a look at it. Communication tower. Oh yeah, that's a massive DOI. Look at the size of that thing. Can you guys see that? Oh, that's not working. That's not good. Yeah, that's a bit of a beast. No, I think this is the one that we took in vanilla. When I was playing with Lighted and Laney and Iron Wolf and Johnny and that lot on a live stream once. Took 5 tanks. It's got shields. The defenses, though, don't by the look of it. Give it another ping. Yeah, we've got a lot of drone activity here. I'm not sure what sort of weaponry is on that HQ either. Probably nothing friendly, obviously. Something that big is probably going to be a lot of sort of hit and run kind of. Oh, yeah, go Overseer. Overseer's attacking the Zirax. I love that. Love to see that. That's awesome. So a little park here then. Nothing shooting at me, which is great. Happy days. Let's have a little look outside. Gotta make sure as well that actually can survive outside here. Right. Let's have a little look-see. Okay, we've got some standard laser cannons by the look of it on that thing. The HQ itself, again, looks just like normal laser cannons. With the shield generator on the top there. Ow. What the freaking Zirax asshole with a rocket launcher. Sit down. Go minigun turret. Come on. Oh, butthole. And that guy over there's got plasma and laser cannons, but that's the normal communication tower, which we know we've taken before. To be honest, it's the Zirax lasers that I'm more worried about. Now the defense posts and stuff. I might be able to take them down at range. What's that? It's got one laser cannon on it? Okay. Not really much of a threat. Combined, though, the whole lot is quite a threat. Individually, not so much. Let's see if we can get the Scorpion out. I can't remember what loot was in that communication, that headquarters, but it was a bitch of a POI. We can get to it without all the other bases around it, then we're onto something, aren't we? This is probably going to take a while though. What the hell? Hey, really? Little spider, look. Sit down. Right, 1900 rounds, 50 shots with that. Right. And, light is fading. Probably gonna need some kind of, I don't know. Don't have a zoom, do we? This is the thing with controlling a turret, you have a zoom. Ah, what the frick? Why are my shields not coming up? Son of a. Dented my tank, you freaking frick. Get him. So, why are you turrets not killing the Zirax before they freaking shoot a rocket at me? Come on. Shields. Let's go. It's difficult to see amongst the sea of red names. Oh, yeah, I had shields up that time. Bitch. Like that. What is the defense post? I think that's the defense post. Oh, yeah, that drops way before.
Right, let's have a little, have a closer poke. And that went over, so that's good. I'm in range. Oh, this planet sucked. Go away. My God. Zirax territory, man. Freaking nightmare. Right. Anyway, before I so rudely interrupted, I was trying to shoot that base over there. Put that in before it. Or is it this one here, actually? Oh yeah, see that hit? Bingo! See? One defense down. And then a whole another troop of freaking Zirax arrive. Bingo! Another defense down. Another defense all the way over there by the looks of it. Might be able to get out from here with enough arch on the old artillery cannon. Oh my God, I blew something up. Boom, another one down, at range as well. That one's next. I got a pleuropod messing with my hovers. Come on! Behave yourself. Get out of it. Sneaky little bugger. There, one went over. Bingo. Another one. Bombing the Zirax from a distance. I love it. There goes a turret. Inco's another turret. Oh man. Yeah, their asses kicked, don't they? Ooh, I got a positron beam on me. Ooh, hello. That was close. Running low on ammo here. Yep, I got two more artillery rounds and a few more 15 mils or whatever they are nowadays, and then I'm done. And that thing is now in range. What are you? Come on, you guys are serious right now? Get out of it. Get free. Oh, there's a freaking timber wolf. No big deal. Glide past that a second. Yeah, that guy's firing missiles at me. Okay, that's serious. Definitely have to take that turret out. There's my two last shots. Not sure if I got him or not. It was a pretty big explosion, so I might have. Alright, let's head back to ship. Let's refill ammo. And see if we can do the last little leg of this campaign. We've got down. So out of those, all these defenses are down. And the fusion reactor there is also heavily damaged. The stealth outpost also heavily damaged. Communication outpost I'm not worried about. Let's press on with the Scorpion. I'm thinking about switching over to the Charger and doing a bombing run on the actual headquarters itself to get the shields down. I don't know whether getting the shields down will, they'll then stay down once they're down, if you know what I mean. But if we get the shields down, that shield generator is on the top. I can bomb it out, get back in the Scorpion, and snipe the turrets off. Just getting a gauge on the headquarters' shields there. Notice that doesn't move from 100%. If I hit it with an artillery, it doesn't move from 100%. You're blowing up your own bases there, buddy. Yeah, see? Direct hit, 100%. So the only way I'm going to be able to take that down is with a lot of laser cannons, and it has got a lot of turrets on it. This is going to be one dicey, dicey job for the charger. Hit and run with its four laser cannons plus its four laser turrets, hopefully doing their job as well, and hopefully getting out of there before taking damage on the shields, or the shields going down, I should say. All right, let's try this, shall we? All right, shields at maximum, thrusters ready, laser cannons ready. I don't know what time, what point we can start firing. I'm just going to start firing straight away. Oh, crikey. That knocked 2% off. Not enough. Oh, shit. Evasives. 59, 58% shields. Back up to 100% on the base, though. 35% shields. Oh my god. Get out of here. 15% shields. A lot of rockets following. Okay, I managed to take 3% off, and it's already recharged to 100% by the, because I've got to run away and recharge my shields. This is probably not going to work. In fact, I could say with absolute confidence this is not going to work, because I just can't output the damage to the shields needed to get them down. Something much bigger and angrier needs to take that on, unless there is a built-in weakness in that thing. No, what am I doing? I'm not ready yet. What do the rockets do? The rockets despawn. They don't fly until they hit the ground like the artillery does. The artillery doesn't do enough. Every time, by the time it's reloaded and recharged, it's the shields are back up again. I can't sit there. I've got to swing around and do another run. Oh my lord. Nearly hit the ground then. Abort. Yeah, reloading, look. Great timing. 40% shields. The artilleries on that make that a nightmare for tanks as well, because the tanks are more likely to get hit by artilleries. Say with like a CV or something. My god. What can one do against such shields? I say I had an SV with the gamma ray, the actual, like the gamma freaking laser cannons. I don't even know if I've got them on the thing. Are they buildable, or are they like something we need to find? Yeah. So, modulated laser gamma, very effective against shields. Very expensive in every single sense. Could down a shield pretty quickly, even just like two of them. Probably do more than these lasers on there. Oof. As for sort of weaknesses, like, can we get under the guns, like with a Scorpion tank? I'm not sure we could. Doesn't look like there's much in the way of, like, holes in the wall or anything. Oh, hello, cheekies. Jesus, there was a lot of laser fire from the ground there. Because that's the only other option, is that we infiltrate in the ground. Man, I bet what some of you are saying, Spanj, why don't you just dig under it?
To that I say, nay! Boring. Come on, shields, recharge ready. Let's go. I need another look around that perimeter fence. They're like a hangar door or something that'll open if I fly near it or something like that, you know? There is a hangar bay there, a little tiny one. Tiny one on the left side. I think it's too small for a charger to fit in there. But it might fit like something else. Like a scorpion tank. A wild dash across the fence, you know, like I could jump over the fence. The thing is once I get in there, if I were to get a scorpion tank in there, would it get shot up the bum? There's one there. And there might be another one over there as well. But they look really narrow. I don't even think a scorpion will fit in there. And by the time you get it to, like, the fence... The other option is we hide. And see if we can shoot around corners. Ooh. Mother duckers. Can we shoot around corners? Now, the missile turrets don't have a lot of... Oh, don't you bloody start, mate. No way for you, sunshine. Sit down and shut up. Oh, there's a laser turret I left on that POA. Missile turrets don't do a lot against shields. Are you kidding me? What the hell is coming up behind me now? Where did you come from? You little dick. Sit down. 40% shields. You all done now? Can I have some shields back, please? The old hide technique. Yeah, a position where the guns can't shoot you, but you can shoot them. Take the shields down, bomb that freaking shield generator out, and we might have a chance. 88% shields. I'm at 90, 89. All four firing. Yeah, there we go. Wait, I'm not hitting something for some reason. There we go. Taking return fire here. Sixty percent shields. They're down to 54. Problem is, I then got to be able to shoot shield generator. Forty percent shields. Come on, laser guns. We're at 20%, I'm at 38. Yeah, mom. 29% shields. They're at 5%, 4%, 2%, 0. Get rid of those rocket turrets. 13% shields. 9% shields. Jesus Christ, how much hit points have these bastards got? 5% shields. I gotta bop 'em out. Right, do these GIFs headquarters recharge their shields? I assume they do. They got a shield generator on the top. Let's get my shields back up. Now I know I can get its shields down. Targeting the shield generator and getting shot by lasers on the left. Very noisy in here. Bingo, shield generator is down. Bingo, there goes that laser turret, missile turret. That's an EMP turret, so that's going to rip my shields down very quickly. Except the fact it's not really, it is hitting me, sorry, ignore me. 50%. Boom. It's gone. It's gone. It's gone. Perfect. Then we got the big boys. Artillery cannons.
Hoo-hoo-hoo.
At what point did the Zirax start just killing their own base just to get to me? Yes. Excellent. Good. Good. Destroy yourselves. Let's do a little pop. Oh, hello. So we got positron laser. Now here's a question. Can I get underneath those ones? I'm not sure. The big red ones, the cross ones, they have a very good gun depression. Really, really good gun depression. Now the other Zirax ones, the dome type turrets, they have terrible gun depression. You can get under them very easily. Positron beam on me. See, a lot of these the turrets I would like to salvage, so if I can get them down on one side, I think I could probably get in there, disable it, and then salvage, you know, take the core out, salvage the rest kind of thing. But I'm going to need to get rid of those three turrets and probably those two turrets on the left hand side to get a clear enough area where I can approach. Hide and seek technique worked though, or is working, I should say. There goes the positron beam. Get that EMP turret down. There goes the EMP turret. Woo, hello, that was a big explosion on my shields, 37%. Let's hold off for a second before we go back out again. Meanwhile, my laser turrets are taking out the generators of the stealth outpost. No big deal. What a bloody legend. Hi. Miss me. There goes the artillery turret. Means we've got missile turrets over there and another ion cannon on there, but I think we can probably get to this position here and just get shot by everything over here. Oh, there's still a lot going on, isn't there? Oh my god. Whew. And we got the ground troops actually inside the headquarters now, and there's another turret that I haven't been able to take out yet on the stealth outpost there. We're gonna bomb the bejesus out of that, I think, and then we can make our approach on the headquarters. We can get around the guns that are currently left on there, so there's a positron beam on the right hand side. What other things? There goes that one. We're getting beamed. That turret's gone. We can get out of here. Alright. Making the Zirax shoot their own base is brilliant. I love it. But there you are. I was waiting for your little freaking homing signals. Thank you very much. Oh, still one up. When he was in shields. Bugging out. Something I should have done. You're probably shouting at me in the chat to do. Is that activating my marksman mission? I don't know how many Zirax I would have killed by now. But then all the Zirax have been killed by the kind of like turrets and stuff, so I don't think it would have counted anyway. Right. Let's have another little poke at this thing then. 9% shields. Oh boy, I gotta get out of it.
The it's the ground troops and the sentry guns is doing a crazy number on my shields at the moment. It's ridiculous.
Right.
Blowing up a lot of boxes right now, but they're only little boxes. They're not like big loot crates, so I'm not terribly cut up about it. But the point is, we have a way in. Right, these turrets need to be off of those and on those, although in fairness it's probably going to make them shoot through the POI. Yep. Let's maybe just leave them off then of bases altogether, just deal with the crap around me. Okay, right. This is another thing I gotta be very careful about while here. It's not dying. I have an extended look around at the moment, just making sure. Like, nothing's. As soon as I pop out my cockpit, I'm not gonna just die instantly. I have got armor on. I've got mobility and armor. Yep. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the GIST headquarters. We made it. All right, and we're going to be finishing this bad boy off in the next episode. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for watching. I get far too much pleasure from doing this. I'm sorry, not sorry. But I hope you enjoyed the siege part of this this siege, and hopefully I will see you next time for the conquering of the POI. Thank you very much for watching. Hope you enjoyed, and hopefully I'll see you next time. Until then, take care. Bye-bye.